Yes, children, today I will start with the circulation of blood through the heart. Now, the distribution of blood to the various body parts and collect blood from them. In order to distribute blood to various body parts and to collect from them, the heart undergoes regular contraction and relaxation. So day and night, it moves rhythmically. The contracted phase, when the heart contracts, then that phase is called systole or systolic phase. And the relaxed phase, when it dilates, then that phase is called diastolic phase or diastole. During systole, the volume of the chamber of heart decreases. When the heart is in the systolic phase, it means in the contraction phase, the chambers of the heart will contract, the volume will decrease, and the pressure inside will increase. That pressure will push the blood to the succeeding following chamber. Whereas during diastolic stage, that is when the heart is relaxing and expanding, then the volume of any chamber of the heart increases and the pressure will decrease. That is why this diastolic phase, then that chamber will receive the blood from the previous chamber, preceding chamber. All the chambers of the heart neither beat simultaneously nor one by one, but follow a definite pattern. Various events that take place during circulation of blood through the heart are as follows. Deoxygenated blood from all the body parts is being poured, collected and is being poured into the right auricle of the heart by two main blood vessels, superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Then side by side, simultaneously, the oxygenated blood from the lungs is collected and is poured into the left auricle by four pulmonary veins. So finally, the right auricle gets the blood, deoxygenated blood, and the left auricle gets the oxygenated blood. When the auricles, they are full of blood, a wave of contraction starts. It is the auricles that starts contracting first. And this wave of contraction passes from one end to the lower end. The ventricles, that is the lower chamber, at this time are relaxing and are empty. Thus, the blood from the auricles, when the auricles contract, enters into the systolic phase, comes in contraction phase, then the blood from the auricles passes into the ventricles easily. The wave of contraction passes from upward to downward. Therefore, when the blood from the auricles, they are being pushed into their succeeding ventricles, the two cuspid valves, that is the tricuspid valve between the right auricle and right ventricle, and the bicuspid valve between the left auricle and the left ventricle, they remain open and allow the blood to flow into their respective ventricles. Now, the wave of contraction, which starts from the auricle, slowly from the top comes down to the lower end. It flows down this contraction phase, passes now into the lower chamber, that is into the ventricles. And now the ventricles start contracting. Now the blood, when the ventricles, see this figure, the ventricles are contracting. So the blood from the ventricles under pressure will try to return back into their respective auricles, but the tricuspid valve and the bicuspid valve, they get tightened up with the pressure of the blood. They get tightened up, swells up, and the cordy tendini stretch them, swell them up, tighten them up, and this opening, the aperture between the auricle and ventricle, both the apertures, this tricuspid and bicuspid valve, they close, thus prevent the backflow of blood from the very ventricle into the respective auricles. So the blood from ventricles under pressure tends to return to auricles, but the flaps of two cuspid valves get tightened and puffed up, thus closing the passage and preventing the backflow of blood to the auricles. The cordy tendini holds the flaps of valves in position and prevent their overturning into the auricles, and thus the opening is closed. This is the function of cordy tendini. Cordy tendini can be compared as the cords of parachute. Now the blood from the, as the ventricles are contracting, the cuspid valves are closed, the blood cannot go back to the auricles. So the only way left out for the blood to enter is from the right ventricle. The blood will enter into the pulmonary artery, which is present at the origin of the right ventricle. And the blood from the left ventricle will get only the passage to make the entry of the blood into the aorta. So the blood from the ventricles will get only these two entries. So from the right ventricle, it will enter into the pulmonary artery, and from the left ventricle, the blood from here will go into the aorta. Once the blood enters into these two blood vessels, due to force of gravity, the blood will tend to flow back. But as the blood tends to flow back, the semilunar valves present at the opening between the ventricle and the pulmonary artery and between the right ventricle and the aorta, the semilunar valves, which are half moon shaped, they will form a cup-like structure, half cup-like structure, and will close these openings of these blood vessels into the ventricle. So the blood will not return back to the ventricles, and there is no other way left out. So the blood will be forcefully taken in from the pulmonary artery, will move out of the heart and will go to the lungs for oxygenation. And the blood from the aorta, when it will not be allowed to come back into the ventricle, will move out, carrying the oxygenated blood out of the heart to be provided to the different parts of the body. So the blood from the right ventricle passes into the pulmonary arteries, whereas from the left ventricle into the aorta, backward flow of blood is prevented by semilunar walls present at their beginning, at the beginning of the or the origin of these blood vessels. In this way, deoxygenated blood is supplied to lungs for oxygenation through pulmonary artery, whereas oxygenated blood is supplied to all the body parts by the way of aorta. Now, when the heart enters into the systolic and diastolic phase, the heart produces a particular type, two types of sounds. So, contraction of the heart is accompanied by a number of mechanical and sound manifestations. It can give us the idea of its dynamics when recorded. By using a stethoscope and applying the ear near the position, we can hear two types of sounds in the heart. The first sound is lub, which is a long booming sound and produced by the closure of auricular ventricular valves, that is tricuspid and bicuspid valves. When they close, they produce a sound lub, and this happens at the beginning of the ventricular systole, that is the ventricles are contracting. And when the ventricles will contract, you know, the blood will try to go back into auricles. Immediately the tricuspid and bicuspid valve will fall down and close sharply, producing a sound called lub. The second sound produced is dup, which is a short, sharp sound and is produced due to the closure of semilunar valves. These valves are present at the origin of pulmonary artery and the aorta. And this is produced at the beginning of ventricular diastole. When the ventricles are started relaxing, then these semilunar valves, they close sharply, and these are the semilunar valves. They close sharply and will not allow the blood from these two blood vessels to flow back into the ventricles. So this is how the sound is being produced, which can be heard or can be made out with the help of an instrument called stethoscope. Tomorrow I will take the types of blood circulation. Thank you, children.